Along with this idea of a personal hub, we have the visualization concept of cards. And cards are small units of information that you can see, and you can look at it and say, yep, that is the information I was waiting for. That was the payment for a service I was waiting for. So let's say you want to join a group, you want to become a member of a network and participate in a shared economic destiny that is coordinated by a blockchain or a decentralized app built on a blockchain like Ethereum. The way the cards would work is that it would take information that exists in the blockchain and reflect it to you. Your status, your balance, if it is a payment. And that's really what the blockchain is. It's a source of the information that feeds into this card that you can see, and it provides you options within the card itself. What do you want to do next? Do you want to accept this? Do you want to reject it? Do you want to file a complaint? Do you want to transfer this? And that's all encapsulated within that card-based interface, where when you click a button, when you zoom in, when you expand out, it might go to the blockchain, or may go beyond the blockchain to find more information to enrich. So what can you do next? You can send it to someone, but on a more traditional cloud services. Now you're taking blockchain information and bridging it to an existing messaging system. And that's all coordinated through this card UI and then implemented in your own personal hub. But when you're dealing with it on your phone, it looks no different than a friendly messaging app that you've been using on your Android and iOS phone.